Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. We're going to look at the new version of Snagit 2020, and I'm going to show you my favorite five features, advanced features these are, and this is going to include the new updates as well from the 2019 to the 2020 edition. Really hope you like the video. As always, if you do, please like it, please share it, please comment on it, and of course subscribe to my channel. Let me show you my five favorite advanced features in Snagit 2020. Now, I've just turned off the webcam while I do this first example. I want to point out that we can now use Snagit to create mini marketing videos that we might put on LinkedIn or on Facebook or on Twitter, and it really is a great tool for this, and I'm going to show you the whole process really quickly. So I'm going to click on capture. I'm on Snagit. This is my capture window. I'm just going to minimize this, and for this particular example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my website, and now I'm just going to image capture this website. So I'm going to click here and just mark the area that I want to include. So I'm going to do that, and I'm going to just image capture that. So that's been image captured. Now I'm going to do one more image capture. So I'm going to click on image capture again, and this time I'm going to open up my YouTube channel. So I've got my YouTube channel on the screen. I'm going to click on capture, and this time I'm going to mark this area here. So we've done basically two image captures. Now what I'm going to try and do is create a video that first of all talks about the first one and suggest people sign up to my newsletter, and then suggest that they also subscribe to my YouTube channel. What I'm going to do for this then is turn that into a video, and then I'm going to share that on LinkedIn, and I'm going to share that on Twitter and on Facebook. Now to do that, it's very, very simple. I'm going to choose by holding down my control key the two images, and then I'm going to click on create video from image, and now it's going to turn on the video recorder. Notice it's also picking up my voice. I can choose the microphone I'm going to use. Now I use my other microphone while I'm doing this, and I'm just going to simply take you through this process. So I'm going to start with this image first, or no, I'll start with this one. I'm going to click on this button here. Notice also that I can use these tools here on the right hand side. Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. Don't forget to come over and subscribe to my YouTube channel. There are now nearly 10,000 subscribers to the channel. So I click on the pause button. Now I'm going to come over to Teacher Training Videos as well. Okay, carry on with the video. Don't forget as well, you can also sign up to my newsletter if you want to be updated with all the latest webinars and blog posts I write, as well as the online courses and the new videos I've created. And it's done. I've done that video. Let's play it back. I'm obviously doing this very quickly, so it's not particularly professional, but you'll see what I mean. Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. And notice also, don't forget to come over and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If we play it for a little bit, we'll just speed it up rather than spend too time that it show. We get the animation on the screen and the same thing again. Okay, and now I can literally just click on save as, and I've made myself a little mini marketing video based on a few images. I mean, of course, these could be images perhaps from a presentation I was recently giving, or from a visit I've done, whatever. I just want to make a quick video and maybe add some animation into it. I can do it so easily now in the new version of Snagit 2020. If you're a teacher, you're going to love this example. It's one that I often show. I've shown it previously. It's still available in 2020. What I'm going to do is I've just searched on Google for images, and I've made sure that the image that I'm searching for is labeled for reuse, so it's an image that I can legally use. I'm going to click on this image here. This one will do fine. In fact, if I click through it, it will bring me through to the website. In fact, it might be better to take the image just from here. I'm going to click now and open up Snagit, and I'm just going to capture that particular image. So I'm just going to mark out that area around there and capture that. Again, I'm doing this a bit quick, and I know that wouldn't be perfect because I've managed to capture these bits, but just to demonstrate the idea. Now what I'm doing is I'm going to click up here, and I'm going to click on the steps, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a worksheet, and I want my students to name these objects in English. Perfect for language. It could be teaching Spanish, English, or Chinese, or whatever. So I'm going to put here, first one's going to be obviously screen, second one's going to be cable, third one's going to be keyboard, fourth one's going to be mouse. Fifth one's going to be mat. Sixth one's going to be computer. Seventh one is going to be stand. So I've now created my image and I need to paste that into a Word document and then turn it into a kind of worksheet. So I'm going to click on the button up here, copy all. Now all I need to do now is open up Word and paste that image in. So I've got a Word document up here, and all I'm going to do now is I'm just going to simply press Control V and paste in that image. See how easy I can do that? I don't even need to actually save it. Now I'm going to come down here and I'm just going to put write the correct word, and then we'll do number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven. And I've got myself super quickly, obviously I'll do it more professionally, a worksheet that I can then copy, give to the students, and they would have to write in the correct word in whatever language that I wanted them to practice it in. Of course it could be sentences, for example, but you see how quickly I can use that numbering feature in Snagit to create a worksheet. Okay, this next feature is very interesting. It's one that I've actually ended up using quite a lot. And this would actually be a really good example. Imagine, for example, I've image captured this, and obviously it's kind of difficult to, if I want to highlight things and add in text, I'm very limited with the space that I've got because I've only really got this small area up here maybe to add some text in. So what I need to do really is to create some space on the image. And we can actually delete whole chunks of this image and then replace them with a color that's, for example, in the background. So I'm going to just show you how I can do this. I'm going to click on select, and I'm going to select this image here, and we'll do it with this one here as a perfect example. And then I'm going to click on autofill, and then I've got various options. And what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to delete this, and amazingly what's going to happen is the image is going to disappear and it's going to be filled with the background color. And it's just completely gone. And this can be really useful if now I then wanted to have that extra space to highlight things, etc. So that would be one really useful example of where we could use it. Another example is if you've got an image and then you want to tell your designer, well, delete this or delete that, so you can actually remove the things and show them exactly how you want the layout of your website to be created. And it's a feature that I've actually ended up making quite good use of. It's this kind of autofill feature in Snagit. That was available in 2019, and again, it's of course available in 2020. Snagit is a brilliant tool for doing thumbnails, and in fact the thumbnails that I create, the images, if I ever want to make an image perhaps to put on YouTube or on Instagram, I always use Snagit to do this. So I'm going to do a really quick example again just to show you what I mean by this. So if I go to my desktop and I'm going to come down to new thumbs, and what I'm going to do is just grab an image that I'm going to then turn into a banner. So we'll grab this one here. I quite like this image. I bring this image into the screen. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make the canvas of this much bigger. So I'm going to pull out the canvas. Okay, so I'm making this a lot bigger here. And then what I'm going to do is click on this button here, click here and paint that another color. And now I'm going to resize that to be exactly the size that I want the image to be. And I want it to be 1280 by 720. And that is very typical for the thumbnail images that we put onto Twitter and onto, particularly onto YouTube. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some text. So I'm going to click here and make sure that I've got it in white. I'm going to choose perhaps impact, which is the one I normally use. And I'm going to make that a lot bigger. I'm going to use about, let's put it up to 79. I'm now going to mark an area on the screen, and I'm going to write my latest video. Now I can save that now and then upload that as an image into YouTube or as an image to go in front of a video that I've got perhaps on LinkedIn, etc. So okay, and for my fifth example, we're going to come back now to Snagit 2020. So this is a feature that you can only use in 2020. 2019 is a great technology as well, but 2020 does offer these additional image from a template and image from a video. Now, we've already seen image from a video. We're going to look at image from a template. This is great for creating worksheets. And though so far I haven't used this, there's already clearly a moment when I am going to to use this because this is ideal for creating handouts. And I'm just going to give you an example. I'm going to choose this template here. So I'm creating a template. And what I can now do is I can grab assets that I want to use in this handout. Now let's imagine, for example, that I'm going to be doing a presentation and I want my audience to have information about my website and about my YouTube channel. Well, I'm going to drag that video into that image, sorry, into the top one. This image I'm going to drag into the bottom one. Notice that they immediately go in. Now I'm going to put a title here, and the title is going to be very simple: how to contact Russell, or how to follow Russell. Okay, and you can see that I can kind of create a really nice document. I'm going to say follow or Russell's channels. Let's just put that there. Okay, so I'm making a template super quickly. I can of course click here and begin to add some text and add some more text here, and suddenly I've created for myself basically a kind of handout, a document that I can then print and use, for example, when I'm giving a presentation. This would be brilliant for teachers making handouts that they want to give to their students. And the great thing is, any image that they've either opened up into Snagit or that they've image captured and they've got, they can then drag them in and make use of them. And that's a really nice feature that's just been introduced into Snagit 2020. Okay, really hope that was useful. If you're looking for more videos, please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. There's a special section on Snagit, and it's got videos from 2019 and 2020. If you'd like to keep up with my work, then please sign up to my newsletter. That way you're up to date with all the webinars that I run, the online courses I do, where I'm presenting, new videos that have come out, the blog that I write, etc. If you want to access all the backdated content, then the best place to do that is on the YouTube channel. Absolutely masses of stuff, lots of stuff on Snagit and Camtasia, etc. If you'd like me to do a presentation for your organization or a workshop, then please contact me on my website, but also for online training, because I have a webinar tool that allows me to do very interactive online training, either one-to-one or one with a group of participants. Thank you very much.